What is going on, guys? We're here with Ray Scarface versus Solvent for Smoke and Snake Draft. And looking at the teams, I assume this is a Choice Packs Chandelure. A D.Va Mew with either Earthquake or Ice Beam. Looking at the team, he has a Clefable to check Zygarde, so this might have a ground move to hit Heatran. I assume this is a Scarf Landers because Rocks should be on Clefable on this team. A Mega Venusaur. And standard defense of Celesteela. And looking at Ray's team, he has a regular Hooper. This could be a Nasty Plot variant, or this could be a Specs Hooper. Most likely a Mega Lardy, and then his team's quite slow, so this could be Scarf Greninja. It doesn't necessarily have to be Scarf since he has a bulky backbone, but it's definitely an option. So there's gonna be a Rocks Tran, I think just Magma Storm Trapper with lefties. But it could also be Z-Move Tran, and the other potential Z-Move user would be the Hooper. I don't think he's Z-Move Ground on this team, like I said, he should be Scarf. Defensive Backbone with Tang and Pex. This is obviously going to be Toxic Spikes. He has a Veno to absorb T-Spikes, and Clef has Magic Guard, so Solvent should be fine. But in that regard, Hooper can definitely put in some work versus Solvent's team, and potential threat from Solvent's to Ray's team. Yeah, Chandelure, if this Toxic Apex is more Fizz Def, it's gonna be tough to switch into a potential Specs Shadow Ball from this. Greninja can only switch in once, I'm pretty sure, yeah. Everything else gets destroyed if, like I said, if this is more Fizz Def. I mean, Tangrowth can potentially switch in if it's AV into a Shadow Ball, but it cannot switch into a Fire move. So looking at leads here, okay, never mind, I already picked the leads. I was trying to like figure out what would be a smart lead. So the taunt is an option here, so if I'm Solvent here, I would switch out and predict the taunt. He stays in, but he still predicts the taunt, makes a fire play, goes for a knockoff. I assume we're gonna see the rocks now from Ray. Mew. The screaming that he has off power. So if I wouldn't stay in here, if I was Ray, I would just go into either Toxapex or Tangrowth. Maybe even Lardy. But yeah, staying is risky because he already lost his lefties and he okay, stays there. Now his turn is super low. He taunts, so now the Solvent can't defog. I assume that now he's gonna switch into one of these three here. He goes into Hooper, that's the Clefable. This already showed knockoff. So if this is Specs, it would die to knockoff, I'm pretty sure. But if it's Z-Move, it can potentially... I think it can live a knockoff if it's Z-Move. So depending on that, Ray is gonna run a Kalk and he will know if he can live a knockoff. And potentially Nasty Plot up if he's a Z-Move variant, and if not, he can just... If he's not a Z-Move variant, he can switch... into what though? Because his Heatran is super low. But yeah, Solvent is definitely gonna go for knockoff here. Super is a threat to him, if this is... Like, Solvent doesn't know the set yet. So if it's Specs, it's like rough for him to switch into. And knockoff is obviously his play to make here. And yeah, I assume... If Ray has Nasty Plot, then Z-Move he's gonna go for it, and if not, he's gonna switch. But he goes for it. He does get crit. He definitely was Z-Move. He didn't lose an item. He crit mana for sure. Like, otherwise he wouldn't have made that play, right? So this is rough now for Ray. His Heatran is already low. His Hooper is already dead. Yeah, he has Rocks up, but the Mew is gonna be able to defog on quite a few months. Like, it's gonna be, it outspeeds the trend, if I recall correctly, right? It did. Yeah, it did outspeed the trend. And you can also default on the Tangrowth, on the Toxapex. Unless the Toxapex is like toxic, has toxic, then it can punish the Mew. But since trend is, he's got a Magma Storm here, I assume. Since trend is almost dead, if rocks are gone once, it's gonna be hard to get them back up. So Solvent can just go for a defog here. As we assume, we're gonna see a switch into, okay, into Greninja. So this is either gonna go for U-turn or, like, this probably has its U-turn Scarf, or if not, it has Dark Pulse, and Solvent is gonna get threatened out. So he can go to Clef or the Celesteela here. He goes to Clef, he sees U-turn, so it's most likely Scarf. And there's still an option of this having Gunk Shot. I assume the other moves are like Rock Slide and Ice Beam. Hydro Pump is also an option for sure. But yeah, I assume he's just gonna get the rocks back up here. If you're Solvent here, would you go hard into Chandelure? Yahalden Mew is a fine play. Yahalden Mew is a completely fine play because he's fast and he can softball on heat turn. I can see Rice Dan in predicting a defog, but it's not worth it. Yeah, just switches. But Mew's getting back healthy with leftovers. This time, if he has a move to hit the Clefable, he can go for it. So if I was Solmond, I would have gone to Celesteela there. Now his Clefable is low, but it's fine. Because he can. If I was Solmond here, I would consider softballing because the double is quite obvious. So he goes in heat turn predicting the Celesteela, but Landorus was also a fine play there. Landorus and Chandelure all, like these, Celesteela, Lando, and Celesteela, Lando, and Chandelure all were options because he was locked into a gunk shot. Even Venusaur could have came out, but these three were more likely. So yeah, Solmond can either go for like a U-turn to get momentum because he's not going to stay into second turn, or he can go for like, maybe a knockoff if he has that to get rid of an item. I assume we're gonna see a switch into Lati or Tangrowth here. I don't think he's ever gonna stay in with a Trent. So he goes into Tangrowth. We do see the knockoff to get rid of the Assault Vest. There's definitely, I mean, it's nice for Solmond, but it's, yeah, it's nice for Shadow Ball spam. That's yeah, definitely nice for that. But like Tangrowth itself is not a threat to him. He has a Mega Venusaur. As, he predicted the Venusaur or something there. He predicted the Vino or the Clef to come out, probably the Vino. Double back into Heatran. Solmond goes for a double knockoff, makes a fire play. And yeah, Solmond is really far ahead already, so it's gonna be tough for Ray to come back. He knows this is locked into knockoff. But the Clef is free here for Solmond, so like, he can just go Clef. Scald doesn't kill from this range. If he goes for T-Spikes, he can absorb them later with Venusaur. Clef would not care about the Toxic, and yeah, Clef just gets leftovers back here. Now he can softball, then he gets back healthy. I assume he's gonna... Okay, he goes back to Gren. Yeah, he either had to go Gren up or Tangrowth. I mean, if he's a common Lati, he can potentially beat Clef one-on-one, a Mega Lati. But I don't think he's that variant. So this time he goes into Celesteela, not worrying to risk a gunk shot. So he's probably just gonna knock off, try to get rid of the lefties on Steela. But yeah, Thorwin's Mega Vino is obvious. So did he double switch? He did double switch. Like, knockoff would have been a safe play, but yeah. The thing is, like, doubling into Pex doesn't do anything. Like, Clefable comes in every time on Clef. Clefable spams knockoff and gets rocks back up, exactly. And the T-Specs don't matter because he has a Venusaur to absorb them. So yeah, this is looking like, unless he can somehow pull it out with a Calm and Lati, it's looking like a pretty easy win for Solrent here. So he's just, yeah, he always gets a free Vino on Tangrowth to absorb the T-Spike. So he probably predicted him to not go Vino this time, but like, Race Gavis has to bank on the choke at this point. I don't think he can win otherwise. Also, it's Growth Vino, so that's Heat Essence. Ooh, that's fire, so it can break to... he's gonna Haze potentially, so yeah, that's why he attacked. Does he not have Haze? If he does not have Haze, this Venusaur like beats Peck spawn on one. He doesn't have Haze, it seems. I mean, he wasn't wrenched to die from Giga Drain, so it was obvious that he switched. But like, if he had Haze, he should have gone for it, is what I meant. So he goes in the Lati here, you can threaten this out, but someone is like, nah boy, let me stay in. Yeah, he figured it was probably a Defog Lati. So it's not a common variant, and it might be a Bolt Beam Defog Lati. It might also be like HP Fire Ice Beam. I'm pretty sure it doesn't have Psychic Step, otherwise he would have gone for it. There's the Poison. And yeah, that's pretty much over. I think he's gonna forfeit. Yeah, he doesn't have Psychic Step, exactly. So Mega Lati goes down, he can now go into Toxapex or Greninja. And I mean, I guess he's gonna U-turn or hope for a flinch with Rock Slide. Yeah, this game is over. GG. With the explanation marks. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I have some like longer tournament games that I still have to ruminate. This was like a shorter one for sure. Since I'm quite busy today, I was like, let me bring you guys a shorter game at first. If you couldn't tell, this game was a bit older, so like... And yeah, basically I ruminated over it. But like, it was like 2 weeks ago, so I don't even remember what happened in this game. It was like live for me. But yeah, like, that's not much. There's no point in analyzing. The game's over. And he forfeits. And yeah, I have other games. I have like Solvent versus Morbali, stuff like that. Just stay tuned for it. I'll try to bring you at least one more upload. It depends a bit. If I can make more time, I'll bring you like two more uploads later. Thank you guys for watching. Smash that like button if you want to see more Snake content. Ulti content is also going to be coming. And yeah, peace out. Have a fantastic day.